And now, our next bout of the evening, an amateur mixed martial arts bout. Let's welcome in to the blue corner, Simon Pierre Tag.
Journey with me into the mind of a maniac. Doomed to be a killer since I came out the nutsack. I'm in a murderous mind state with a heart full of terror. I see the devil in the mirror. Fuck, fuck, lights out. Cause when I grab my sword off, niggas get hauled off. Barrel one, tears your motherfucking flesh. Barrel two, tears your fucking heart out your chest. You see, I'm quick to let the hammer go click on my tech nine. So if you try to wreck mine, fool at your bedtime. Feel the blast from the chocolate bomber. Infrared, aim at your head like your neighbor Sarah Connor. Decapitation, I ain't hesitating to put you in a funeral. I'm hot like lava. You got a problem, I got a problem solver. And his name is Revolver. It's like a deadly game of freeze tag. I touch you with the phony for mag. And you're frozen inside a body bag. Nobody iller than this graveyard filler. Cat pillar, cause I'm a natural born killer. Terror illustrates my error. Now I can't hang around.
Let's welcome into the cage his opponent, Thomas Magnitus.
Yo, represent, gotta represent. Chase a chick, never chase a chick. No, represent, gotta represent. Chase a chick, never chase a chick. No, mask on, get mask on, mask on, get mask on. Represent, gotta represent. Chase a chick, never chase a chick, no. Two cups, toast out with the gang. From full stops to a whole nother domain. Out the bottle, I'm a living proof. Ain't compromising, half a million on the coup. Houses, looking like Peru. Graduated, I was overdue. I'm a pink, I can barely move. Ask about me, I'm gon' bust a move. Red James, 33 chains. Ocean now, cruising Biscayne. Top off, that's a liability. Hit the gas, boosting my adrenaline. Represent, gotta represent. Chase a chick, never chase a. Represent, gotta represent. Chase a chick, never chase a. Mask on, get mask on.
This next bout is an amateur mixed martial arts bout in the lightweight division, scheduled to take place over three-minute rounds. On my left-hand side, and fighting out of the blue corner, representing LWCA Fight Team from North London, weighing in at 70 kilograms, Simon Pierre Cag. And on my right-hand side, and fighting out of the red corner, representing Revolution Martial Arts from Cyprus, weighing in at 69.5 kilograms, Thomas Magnitus. Your referee in charge, Stu Davies.
We are underway.
And again, these lighter weights always move nice and quick, sharp, crisp fights.
Both guys perhaps just feeling each other out a little bit. Simon's taking the centre of the cage at the moment as Thomas spins around.
Yeah.
Nice right hand there by Thomas.
Yeah.
Goes in for the takedown.
Doesn't get it, looks for the tie-up. Blocking the knee, drives his man to the cage. Kang reverses it nicely. Good little bit of play here. They're both feeling each other out. Kang's got the underhook. Magnitus looking to go down to the leg, but can't. Kang looking to slip and slide that arm in. And then Magnitus dropping low. Has he got the crutch lift here? He's going low. He's got the hand under.
He is looking for it.
But I don't think it's enough right now. Oh,
he's connected hands. He's going for a right.
There we go, and he takes him down nicely into Kang's butterfly guard. Kang instantly looking to get back up, looking at his corner.
Obviously, there. Landing next to the cage, he's going to use it to get up as he just has done. Just needs to extend that right leg. I think he's caught up in the cage at the moment.
Magnus puts him back down. He had hold of that leg, which was causing him problems. But if Kang can continue to try to keep getting up, it's going to make life difficult for Magnus because he can't really progress his position for himself.
Absolutely.
But he's got the double under still. He's got his hands linked. I can see Kang going for another ride.
There he is, going for that left leg now. This time is Thomas Magnitus. He's gone around the neck, but I don't think he'll be able to get that. Shouldn't bother Thomas too much as it's been away. Obviously, it was Thomas that initiated the takedowns, obviously trying to get him down to the ground. So we'll be interested to see now if Simon takes a bit of a back step and tries to keep the distance. Feels more comfortable in the stand-up, perhaps.
Well, he's working nicely behind that jab. He's throwing it out two at a time.
There it is again. Right hand just missed there by Thomas. And another.
Kang's moving nicely, moving side to side.
Nice inside leg kick there by Magnitus. Another right hand straight down the middle landed. Last 10 seconds of the round. So Simon hasn't thrown too many kicks in this round.
No.
It's been very, very hand orientated. Obviously, I think Thomas had the slightly better exchange there with the takedown. Obviously controlled a lot more of the round. The stand-up was pretty even in my view.
Yeah. It was very technical. I think they were pretty even. I mean, Thomas seems to have better hand speed. Kang seems to have better hand speed, a little bit more proficient, working nicely behind the jab on multiples. Magnitus, on the other hand, well, he seems less confident with his hands, moves nicely.
He does.
He's making it very difficult for Kang to get his game on, which is to really control that. And Magnitus is working, moving nicely around. Kang just can't pin him down.
That's it. I would say neither of them really found their range properly in that first round, but obviously one round in the books. We go into the second and we'll see.
But he got the takedown, really controlled it. Nicely done on Magnitus' part in that first round.
There we go. Second round on the way. There's a leg kick there by Simon.
Oh, and he links. Gets into the cage here. Goes for the double link behind the legs. Looking to go below the hips and pick him up.
Much of what we saw in the first round, I think Thomas knows that he can. Obviously, he's got the takedown.
There we go.
Big, big takedown there by Thomas. Obviously, he had success with it in the first round. So he's just gone straight back to it, and it's working for him so far.
And strangely, Magnitus is turning his opponent towards the cage, which is not what I would do at this point. I'd turn him away.
As we saw in the first round, Simon used it to get up, as he's about to do now by the looks of it.
Yeah. And it can be frustrating for the man initiating the takedown, getting it, to have your opponent stand up every single time.
Simon's corner screaming at him to circle away, but Thomas is doing very, very well.
Well,
pinning him against that cage there.
It does mean that he's on the back foot, he's defending everything right now. That's all he can do. Magnitus looking for that high crotch, has to give it up. Goes for the double unders and linking. Oh, and he backs off.
Okay, now let's see what Simon has in the stand-up. He is coming swinging now because he knows he's probably a little bit behind now of that round. He obviously lost the first round. Now there's some urgency in the way he's moving forward, controlling the center. He's being first.
And I think as Magnitus gets more tired, it's going to be more of a problem to stay away from Kang's hands. But he's still giving his, he's still giving it as good as he gets here.
Simon throwing a lot more combinations in this second round.
Oh, and that was a bit of a rush takedown from Magnitus there. He's looking for that pick up again. Not quite in the right position. Swaps to the single. Got both legs under. He needs to get his hips below his head here on lift. And at the moment he's just holding on. Head's in a nice place. He needs to spin off, run the pipe there. He's going to try. Doesn't quite get it. Puts his head on the wrong side. Oh, and Magnitus gives it up.
Last 10 seconds of the round. Second round in the books.
Again, lovely and technical. They both have a game plan here.
They certainly do. Simon wants to stand and trade. Thomas wants to go for the takedown and control it.
Yeah.
Exhausted over there.
I'm not surprised. A lot of that, you know, all that commitment for the takedown, not necessarily getting it, all that work, that's exhausting stuff.
It certainly is.
But it's equally as exhausting having to defend all of that from Kang's perspective. They are both tired by now. This has been a grueling fight thus far from a stamina perspective.
3 minutes left of this lightweight bout. Corner's telling Simon Kang that this is his round. He needs to win this round. Depending on how he scored those first two, but I think Thomas might be ahead.
Nice jab again. Oh, connects with that one. Nice. Tripling up that jab, you don't often see that. Magnitus shoots hard for the double, doesn't get it, comes up short, telegraphed it a little bit.
Magnitus using that jab of his own now. Doubling it up with that right hand. Same again, left, right, left, right, left, right. Simon's got to adjust. I'm sure Thomas will shoot again, and there it is. Straight back up against the cage again.
It was a better shot this time. He got deep on his hips. And he's trying to turn him. He needs to pull him off the cage to keep him on his back at this point.
Simon's corner screaming to him, he's got to get up. Because Thomas will sit there all day.
I think we're going to see him get up, but Magnitus really needs to turn him off that cage so to prevent him using it. Passes his guard now. That's a better position for him. He needs to link those hands.
Magnitus now standing up. Will he go for the takedown again?
Swapping his hands, he's going to look for that single leg.
He'll take his time here, Thomas. There we go, Simon's reversed it.
Yeah.
Not long to work though, just 1 minute left. Nice uppercut landed there.
Good bit of day boxing. Magnitus got the tie clinch on him. He's going to throw the knees. And they break again.
45 seconds. Simon's got to go for this now, I feel. Turning side kick there. Not really much behind it, though. There's that shot again from Thomas, but Simon was live to it, got the double underhooks, sprawled, turned him on the back to the cage. Yep. Now 25 seconds, he'll throw some knees.
Oh! Was that?
Low shot. It's been called a low shot. Simon thought he'd won there.
Yeah. Yeah, it would have been far too quick a stoppage.
Certainly. Yeah. Certainly. Took a low shot. There's not long left of this fight. Simon's taking the minute. Thomas, obviously, I think he's got the five to recover if he wants it. So we've got not long left of this fight. Simon is going to have to go for this. I want to see something spectacular here. Last 10 seconds now.
Again, he's using that jab nicely, connecting with every shot right now.
There's that
goes
shot
for another takedown. Looks on his hips. He's going to commit to it as much as he can. Kang's got it. Stands up again. Lovely work. Oh, no. Throw to the bell.
Great fight there.
Hard one to call, this one.
I think you're right. I think, obviously, Thomas had a large amount of success with the takedowns throughout the whole fight.
Really the first round.
Yeah,
he started to wane a little bit, and he wasn't getting the takedown.
There was some control in the second round against the fence. I think the third round, I think Simon stuffed literally all of his takedown attempts.
Yep.
And sort of led the stand up. So it is a close round, close fight.
I'm going to go with Magnitus on this one.
I'm going to go with Thomas Magnitus.
Magneto, yeah.
And your winner, by split decision, from the red corner, Thomas Magnitus. And put your hands together for his opponent, Simon Kag, Pierre Kag.
Close fight, but a good call.
I think you're right.